following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
Now, I want to begin with something that I think should have aroused a lot more outrage. Most of the people listening to my show, Christian. And what do we Christians believe? Believe that Jesus Christ is God's Son and the only way to salvation. Believe that the Bible is the inspired Word of God. Most of us believe in heaven and hell, and that heaven is for those who believe, and hell is for those who have rejected God. Pretty standard stuff, right? Well, Bernie Sanders, and I'm not quite sure what his religious beliefs are, if any, is grilling President Obama's pick for Deputy Director of the Office of Management and Budget, and how and why his religious convictions would come up for that office is beyond me. But the man that Trump nominated is a Christian and has written about his Christian faith because he was commenting on an incident that happened regarding a woman wearing a hijab. And so he wrote a piece in a publication called Resurgent that Bernie Sanders brought up in this exchange, which is absolutely stunning in his hostility towards religion, towards Christianity in particular. Listen to this.
Let me get to this issue that has bothered me and bothered many other people. And that is, in the piece that I referred to that you wrote for a publication called Resurgent, you wrote, Muslim, quote, Muslims do not simply have a deficient theology. They do not know God because they have rejected Jesus Christ, his son, and they stand condemned. End of quote. Do you believe that that statement is Islamophobic?
Absolutely not, Senator. I'm a Christian, and I believe in a Christian set of principles based on my faith. That post, as I stated in the questionnaire to this committee, was to defend my alma mater, Wheaton College, a Christian school that has a statement of faith that includes the centrality of Jesus Christ for salvation. And
again, I apologize. I do. Forgive me. We just don't have a lot of time. Do you believe that people in the Muslim religion stand condemned? Is that your view?
Again, Senator, I'm a Christian, and I wrote that piece.
Well, what does that say?
The statement of faith of Wheaton.
I understand that. I don't know how many Muslims there are in America. I really don't know. Probably a couple of million. Are you suggesting that all of those people stand condemned? What about Jews? They stand condemned too?
Senator, I'm a Christian.
I understand you are a Christian, but this country is made up of people who are not just. I understand that Christianity is the majority religion, but there are other people who have different religions in this country and around the world. In your judgment, do you think that people who are not Christians are going to be condemned?
Thank you for probing on that question. As a Christian, I believe that all individuals are made in the image of God and are worthy of dignity and respect regardless of their religious beliefs. I believe that as a Christian, that's how I should treat all individuals.
And do you think your statement that you put into that publication, they do not know God because they've rejected Jesus Christ the Son and they stand condemned, do you think that's respectful of other religions?
Senator, I wrote a post based on being a Christian and attending a Christian school that has a statement of faith that speaks clearly with regard to the centrality of Jesus Christ in salvation.
I would simply say, Mr. Chairman, that this nominee is really not someone who is what this country is supposed to be about. I will vote no.
Senator Gardner.
That is absolutely breathtaking. Did you hear him say, I will vote no? And the reason he will vote no is because he's a Christian. Not radical. Not extremist. Christianity 101. Can you imagine Bernie Sanders asking a Muslim that series of questions? Now, you want this position as deputy director of OMB, but I see you're a Muslim. Is it not true that the Quran and religious texts dictate that anybody who isn't a Muslim should submit? should convert, should be killed, or should be willing to pay a tax as a second-class citizen? Is that not true? Can you imagine what would happen if Bernie Sanders said something like that? Stunning.